if you haven't really understood the question, you will miss out on corner cases. It was of, I would say, medium difficulty, not too hard, not easy at all. If you are a newbie into coding, you won't be able to do a single question. But if you have, you know, practiced before, then I'm sure you would be able to crack it. Like, and if I foray into the investment industry as well, like Goldman Sachs, D. Shaw, Morgan Stanley, they're offering a lot of amount.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Udit. Hope you guys are doing well during these hard times. Today I have with us Vrinda Goyal. Vrinda has recently cleared internship interviews of Amazon. Amazon is one of the big companies, and I think most of you would like to apply for Amazon and get an internship over there, right? So I thought it would be great if Vrinda can share her learnings with us. So let's welcome Vrinda. Hi Vrinda, how are you doing?
Hi Udit, I'm good. Thank you for having me.
Great. So can you just give a brief introduction of yourself?
Hi everyone, my name is Vrinda Goyal and I'm pursuing my BTech in Computer Science and Engineering from JP Institute of Information Technology, Noida. And I recently got an offer from Amazon to be a software development engineer intern, and I will be joining them in February 2021.
Okay, so let's start from the very beginning of your experience, right? You interned with Amazon. You are going to intern for Amazon for 6 months next year. So how did you come to know about, like, Amazon provides 6 month internships? Mostly people just try for 2 months intern, right? Like, but you are going to intern for 6 months. So how did you got to know about it?
So in November of 2019, the training and placement cell of my college, JIIT Noida, it sent us a mail that Amazon was going to host a drive for women known as ACMS, that is their Amazon Campus Mentorship Series.
Okay.
So we received this mail in November, and the drive was scheduled for January. So that is how we realized that Amazon provides, like, Amazon is trying really hard for gender diversity. They really want to introduce women in technology, and they're providing us so many drives, so many options are there. So Amazon started with this drive in our college. They came to our college on January 14th of 2020 this year. And that is how I realized that at the end of this mentorship program, that is of 3 to 4 months, I would be provided with an opportunity to interview with them so that I can secure a 6 months internship offer. So that
awesome.
Is how my TNL is basically responsible for it.
Right. So next question is, what do you do in ACMS actually? Is it some kind of mentorship program? Is it some kind of teaching program? Does Amazon people teach you in live classes or something? What actually is ACMS?
ACMS is basically a 3 to 4, because of the pandemic, the duration of the program had to be shortened. Otherwise, for our seniors, it was a 6 month program. So for
okay.
us, it was from March to June, or from March to July. So a 4 month mentorship program. Basically, what it does is there would be 4 classroom sessions wherein we would be taught about coding, machine learning, database development, and various other things that are currently being used by companies while in their development phase. And simultaneously, we were assigned a mentor who was an Amazon employee, and we were assigned a project that we had to work on with our teammates who were young. You know, we were grouped randomly. We just randomly got an email that you guys are a team. So and so is your mentor. This is your project, and you need to work on it over the whole mentorship duration.
Okay.
And at the end of it, we had to interview. So that is literally.
Okay. Okay, so when you were applying for this ACMS program, were there any interviews, or what was actually the process when you were applying for it?
On 14th of January, Amazon came to the campus. They first conducted a seminar wherein they first tried to explain what Amazon is, what it does, the various 14 leadership principles that Amazon is really famous for. And then there was a 90-minute coding assessment wherein there were 28 MCQs and 2 coding questions. The test took place on metal. So the 28 MCQs that we were asked, they were on the topics like object-oriented programming, data structures, time complexities, SQL queries. Some questions were also about computer architecture. So 28 MCQs regarding all these topics that we had previously learned before across our curriculum in our engineering. And then there were 2 coding questions. They were different in different sets. And so anyone who did 1 or 1.5 questions, he or she got selected. So basically, when they came and when they were giving the seminar, they had previously mentioned that only top 10 percentile students would be selected in it. So in our college, about 180 plus girls sat for it, and ultimately 18 girls were shortlisted for this mentorship program.
Great. So one thing is like when you complete ACMS program, right? You said you got an opportunity to interview with them. So Amazon would not be giving this opportunity to everyone. So what do you think are some of the qualities, some of the things which Amazon actually looks for in the mentees before deciding like whether they should provide internship interviews opportunity to them or not?
So the number one skill that any company, be it Amazon, Google, Microsoft, all the big four or the FAANG companies, what they're looking for is problem solving. The basic questions, like for example, if I start by string manipulation, pattern searching, these are very sort of basic questions that we have been applying. So now what these companies want is they want strong data structure, strong fundamentals of algorithm, because when our basics would be clear, when we know how to approach a problem at our level, then only we would be able to apply it on their on the scale that Amazon provides us. And secondly, specifically for Amazon, the 14 leadership principles, it's like it's a must for them. Like they, Amazon literally swears by their 14 leadership principles, and you know, the people cannot fake it in their interview. Like their interview starts, and like while they're giving you a technical question and you're coding it, they're assessing you on those 14 leadership principles, whether you would be a good fit for their organization or not. So specifically for Amazon, problem solving and leadership principles. That's it. That would get anyone into Amazon.
You talked about LPs, right? What do you think, what are some good ways to learn LPs? How did you learn LPs?
In our four classroom sessions that were provided to us, the last session, which took place on 26th of June, it walked us through the Amazon's leadership principles, be it customer obsession, high standards, frugality, and many more. So they literally walked us through. They're like, they are not looking for you to specifically say those words about your personality, because anyway, you are going to give only technical interviews. Like for ACMS, there were no HR interviews. So they're not looking, hi, I'm Brinda, and I really believe in customer obsession. No, they don't want to hear that. But right. When you start coding, when they start talking to you, when you are in a formal dialogue with them during the interview, they would literally make out whether you are going to fit one or more of those principles. So there isn't any preparation that you can do. But of course, there's YouTube. There's this person known as Dan Croyton who forms these videos. So yeah, I just looked at a few of them.
Okay, great. So what was the interview process for the internships when they were converting you when they were taking the interviews for internship, what was the process? What were the kind of interviews were asked? What was the overall format?
On the 6th of July, there were two interviews. Both of them were technical. The first interviewer, he only asked me two coding questions. They're very well read about the format of the interview. My first interviewer came. He told me that the duration of the interview would be 1 hour. I would be asking you two coding questions. The format is that many people think that once we are given the coding questions, we just randomly start typing and giving them the solution. That is not the case in Amazon. We first need to take out time, 2 to 3 minutes, to think about the approach. We have a discussion with our interviewer. And if he is convinced that the approach that you're presenting is optimal for the question that he has asked, then only you're allowed to code the solution on the editor that they've provided. So I was only asked two coding questions, only data structures and algorithms in my first interview. It was of medium difficulty, not too hard, not easy at all. Okay. So the first interview was all about data structures and algorithms. Coming to my second interview, started again with two coding questions. Since there was time left, the interviewer asked me about my favorite data structure, to which I replied linked list. He again asked me a coding question. There was still some time left. So then we started having an open dialogue about how to focus on problem solving. He gave me some tips that you should start doing lead code. Like you've done Geeks4Geeks a lot. So now let's change platforms. Because problem solving skills are what any company is looking for, be it big four, be it startup, be it any company. So it was, for me, it was data structures and algorithms. But for some of my friends, for my mates, the interviewers were asking them operating system, database as well. So it really depends on who your interviewer is.
Only data structures and problem solving was asked, or there were more different topics also, like OSD, BMS, or what all actually topics were asked?
Basically, one will have to brush up on their operating system and networking skills. because you need to clear that coding assessment that I cleared in January, because I had already studied for that. Like, had it not been ACMS and had it been a normal campus opportunity, then I would have given an online assessment wherein they would have asked me questions, MCQs regarding these. So we cannot trade operating system or any other thing for the other. We need to focus on all. But the prime focus, if I were to talk in percentages, 70% data structures and algorithms, and 30% is operating system, DBMS, system design as well. A little bit, Amazon does not want system design. They're very clear with it. But other companies do ask system design questions.
Okay, one interesting question which I always get from people is there any marks criteria when they are shortlisting people?
Not at all. No, it was never the criteria. Even when Amazon came to the campus, the minimum CGPA criteria was 6.5, which is easily achievable. So no, marks were never the criteria. But now, let me point out, now when I'm sitting very calmly without any anxiety, without any stress at my home, because I'm already placed, I am seeing my friends struggle to sit into companies, sit for companies on campus placements because they have very low CGs. Like, it basically depends on companies. From the 3.5 years that I've realized, I've seen that big companies, they do not want high CGs. They do not have high CG standards. But startups, yes, they do prefer people with good CGs. They think that if a person has a good CGPA, he would have good problem solving and development skills as well.
Okay.
Which is how they recruit.
Great. Yep. So what do you think can be a good CGPA if someone is going to sit for placement? Some companies, I mean, every company might be having different CGPA category, right? So what do you think can be a good ballpark number, maybe 6, 7, 8, which someone should maintain so that they will be sure they will be able to sit in almost all the companies or maybe most of the companies?
If you're asking me in terms of sitting for placements, a CG of 7.5 and above will work.
Great.
7.5 and above is like any company comes, you will be eligible to sit for it.
So the next question I have is, so you already said problem solving and coding are the key skills or most important things which companies are mainly looking for when they are interviewing you, right? So when did you start coding? Did you start in the very beginning, like when you joined college, or did you start it late, like when you came to know Amazon is coming and you need to prepare for placements or something? So when did you actually start coding?
So I'll walk you through my entire journey. In the first year, I was literally sulking that I could not get into a good college. So in the first year, I did not do anything. In my second year of college, I wanted to do an MBA because I couldn't do coding. Okay. Then in my third year of college, I came like in July 2019. When I was really getting to see, I was watching my seniors being placed into Amazon, Google, Microsoft, and hearing their packages, it was like, oh my God, you have to do it.
Right.
So then I started doing it. It wasn't the sense that I did not code before. I had to get a good CGPA to qualify my lab tests and everything. I knew what coding was, but I wasn't really interested in it. Then in July, watching these people getting placed, watching my friends getting placed, I wrapped my head around the idea that Vinda, you have to sit and you have to open Geeks for Geeks or HackerRank or LeetCode and you have to start problem solving. Then when in November, the mail came that Amazon is coming in January, that is when it hit me that you're super late and you need to brush up.
Right.
See, a person like me, what I've done is until November of last year, I was reading about data structures. Like, I knew what stacks are, I knew what queues are, where they are used, where they are not used, I knew about it, but I wasn't really typing it on the keyboard. I never really opened code blocks, I never really typed anything because I wasn't interested in it. Then when in November I realized, I wrapped my head that, okay, Amazon is coming, it's coming for women, you do have a chance, let's do this. So as I had studied everything, it was pretty easy for me to just implement it. So per day, I used to sit for 6 hours.
Right.
I used to do coding questions. The agenda was to crack that the online assessment on 14th of January. So the only resource that I followed was Geeks for Geeks. Like, okay. I swear by Geeks for Geeks. It's like, it's the best in the market. There's nothing better than Geeks for Geeks right now.
Right.
So there's this thing called practice section of Geeks for Geeks. It provides us with company-wise questions, topic-wise questions, everything. So my agenda from November till 14 January was to cover arrays, stacks, queues, linked lists, DSP, and trees. That's it. I did not even think that I would be able to do dynamic programming or graphs. It was beyond my reach. And luckily, in my set, there were no questions regarding DP or graphs. So I got through. And then later, when I cracked the test and when I really entered into the program and the online session started happening, so I was clear in my head, okay, you've done this. But in the interview, questions are going to be way harder. And right. and there was a huge window for me from March to July. It's quite some time. And then, and that is when I started doing these questions. Again, 6 hours a day. coding, plus pandemic had already locked us down in our homes. Correct. So nothing else to do. I had already created a good CG, so I wasn't even studying for my college exams or anything. Plus it was online, so everything was open.
Right.
So yeah, everything was quite easy. People were getting 99 SGs. So my CG was pretty good. And I was of the idea ki if I crack it now, I would not even require a CGPA now. Like, right. If I do get an offer, no CGPA is required, nothing is required, everything is chill and sorted.
Right.
So, from March to July, I started coding. I did around 500, 600 coding questions. I literally completed the practice section of Amazon that Geeks for Geeks provided. It has around 550 coding questions. I have completed each and every one of them because it was a do or die situation. If not now, then when?
Right.
So yeah, that is how I did it.
Okay. So what do you think actually, what's a good amount of time a person needs to invest before they can feel like they have so basically, let's say someone's placement is coming up and someone needs to, you know, start preparing. So what's a good amount of time someone needs to invest into coding so that they become good in it? You said you started late, but you did very rigorous amount of coding, right? Because you actually knew like you have started late and you need to do so much of effort. But some people must be joining the college just now, right? What do you think? They should start now or they should also wait for more time or basically for third, fourth year before they start coding?
Start from second year. If a person Correct. Is passionate about competitive programming, if they want to have good profiles on CodeChef, CodeForces and all, then you should start from first year. Because Okay. You can foray into CP only when you know how to do questions on DS and Algo. So I have friends who started from first year. They have good profiles on both of the websites that I mentioned. And now they are preparing from Geeks for Geeks for their campus placements.
Right. Okay. So what kind of questions actually these companies ask, like Amazon kind of companies? I'm not looking only for Amazon, but if you see like Amazon, Adobe, Microsoft, like these big companies, what kind of questions in general do they ask? Do they go into DP and all? What's the level of questions do they keep in the interviews?
For the interviews, I did not get asked any question regarding DP.
Right.
I'll just tell you what my questions were. My first interviewer came. The first question that was asked was, you're provided with a string and you need to find the smallest window size available, which would cover the characters of another string. We discussed it and then I finally came to an approach of O(n) time complexity and space complexity as I was using an unordered map for the same. And my second question was that you have been provided up with a binary tree. And you have to delete an edge of the binary tree such that the product of the sums of both the splitted binary trees is maximum.
Okay.
So this was the question of DFS and like many topics got covered in that. So no DP till now. In my second interview, the first question was that you've been provided a string of parentheses. You need to find out the minimum number of parentheses that you need to add in order to make it balanced. I did it in about 2 minutes. My interviewer said, okay, this is a starter. Let's come to main course.
Right.
So my second question was, that now you've been provided with a string, you have already computed the number that you have to add. Now you have to basically output all the strings wherein you are going to add that X amount of parentheses. So you need to backtrack a little to see whether I've achieved it or not. Many other concepts were covered. Then he came to my data structure. I said linked list. So he asked me to write a code to reverse a linked list in groups of size K from a range M to M. In the best time and space complexity possible. And then a normal question and answering came. So for me, no DP came. Thankfully, I was lucky. But for my friends, some of them, they did get questions on graph, on DP, on backtracking, the queen problem. And so it was basically what the interviewer wants. So if I were to suggest a few topics, it would be one should be very, very clear about basic data structures. Stacks, queues, linked lists, trees, like these are very basic. If not Amazon, other companies will ask you, they will grill you on it.
Okay.
And if you are, for the second interviews, for the first technical round, yes, rounds are pretty easy. But slowly and gradually, as it progresses, you need to have a good grasp over graphs like BFS, DFS, Floyd-Warshall, and all that. So, yeah, that is what it is.